baby in the summer rain. I can hear him singing, ooh, love is strange. Come dance with me, baby, in the summer rain. I remember the rain pouring down, and we poured our hearts out as the train pulled out. I can see my baby waving from the train. It was the last time that I saw him in the summer rain.
Right, everyone, welcome. I'm so excited that a lot of you knew this song. It's definitely from Days Gone By. My name is Maya, and I am here tonight for a lovely replenishing rainstorm. I have been looking forward to this all week long. I don't know about what kind of week you had, but my week, I work in a school district. We started back to school on Tuesday, and it has just been intense. Good intense, but like very intense this week. So I definitely am looking forward to the replenishing. And I am here in Denver, Colorado, where it is in the 90s and it is not raining. I was actually working on my picture this morning and my husband said, "Are you hoping for rain?" I'm like, "Yes, it's so hot." Again, glad to be here. Hopefully everyone has, you can do these activities in your journal, but there's not a specific page for them. It's just blank pages. That's what these exclusive activities are. They're exclusive. They're not in the journal per se. They're just some extra fun things to do. You can use scratch paper. You can use sticky notes, kind of do whatever works for you as you work through this activity. And I loved seeing everyone saying if they would prefer to sing along or if they would rather dance. And a lot of you are going to do both, which is awesome. I think we would have a great Sonderfam sing along, dance along would be super, super fun. So for my new folks, again, this is a little bit different of a social because there's not a specific page in the journal for it. But everyone who is here, we have the self-care gift raffle. So you're all, just by being here, you are all entered into the Sonder Social. Ooh, and Katie, I saw, had put in her notes, she's going to use page 19 in the journal, which is the replenish sketch, because we do not have a social focusing on the replenish sketch. So this is a great opportunity if you're like, I don't know what to put on page 19. Excellent opportunity to do some things in there. So here's what we have. Hopefully you know, for the month of August, which I cannot believe it's the 12th of August already, our theme has been replenish. And I think it's really important to remember, and you'll notice a lot of our socials, we're going to be doing lots of things like making lists and ideas of things that help us replenish. And that's definitely something that's very, very important because, oops, sorry, my phone is ringing. Get that turned off. Because if we have a list and we have these ideas for what will replenish us, then that's going to take us into the busy season, right? We're hitting busy season, end of year, all of that stuff. So replenish really means to fill or build up something or someone again, right? So it's a lot of times, especially after summer, I feel like sometimes we feel a little drained. So if the word replenish doesn't maybe strike the right chords with you, you could also think about refill, refresh, reload, recharge, any of those kinds of things. That's really what we're focusing on this month, is really giving you some time to replenish. So here's our agenda for this evening. We're going to do, I like to call it kind of a little warm-up replenish activity. We'll be making some lists. And then we're going to do a little bit before we get into the replenish rainstorm. We're going to do a little bit of a visualization, breathing, grounding, getting us ready to go into the activity. And then we'll close out. All right. So for our first activity here, what we're going to do is we call this take 10. Right? Take 10 to reflect and replenish. And if you feel like 10 is too many for these things, you can always take 5, right? Or if you feel like 10 is not enough, you can take 15, right? Totally up to you. So again, you can find a blank page in your journal. You can use a sticky note. You can use scratch paper, another blank journal, something like that. So what you're going to do is and I'll show you an example here in a second. You're going to bullet out to 10 three times. So you're going to have three columns and list to 10 in each one. So in section one, you're gonna write out things you're excited for or things you're excited about. So those could be events, those could be people, those could be things, those could be anything that you're excited for. In section two, you're gonna write 10 things that you're grateful for. And then in section three, write 10 things you enjoy doing. So here's mine. It's a little bit blurry, I see. I always have such a hard time. I need to figure out a better way to take pictures of my journal page that looks a little bit sharper. But so I have my take 10 things on that left-hand side, things I'm excited for or about. So we have a vacation coming up in a couple weeks, our annual trip to Ocean City, Maryland. I realize I'm very excited for a lot of sequel movies that are coming out, right? We've got Black Panther 2, Hocus Pocus 2, Avatar 2, Shazam 2, lots of sequels coming out. Very excited for those. We're getting some new landscaping done. There's a yarn crawl that starts this weekend. I'm a big knitter, so not that I need any more yarn, but you know, need is not an issue. I teach a summer class at university and that ends on the 15th. So I'm kind of excited about that coming to an end, excited for fall coming up and the weekend. Grateful for well-paying job, my house, my very thoughtful husband, chocolate, my cats, my family, coffee, my Silk and Sonder fam, my paid off credit cards and tax refunds. Here in Colorado, we got a pretty sizable tax refund this year, kind of a rebate refund from state taxes that we paid. So that was exciting. and then enjoying doing things I enjoy doing. And again, these lists are great to be able to look at later and be like, okay, I need to see what I was grateful for, or I need to kind of see these things that I'm excited about. Again, knitting, watching movies. My husband and I love movies. We went and saw E.T. in the theater in IMAX last night. If you have that in your area, and you, even if you've never seen E.T. before, keep in mind it's an older movie, so the film quality is not great, but it was so fun watching it on the big screen. Loved it. Sitting on our patio, listening to music, dinner and drinks with friends, napping, eating at new restaurants, yarn shopping, reading a for fun book. I read a lot of workbooks, so I like to read things for fun, and learning from others. And that's the other thing that I love about Silk and Sonder here and our socials, is that we really do learn a lot from each other, and it's amazing. So I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to let you make your take 10 lists. Again, if you only want to do five, that's fine. If you want to do more in some columns, fewer in other columns, if you want to get you know, fancy, if you want to do a theme with any of those, do what you like, and let us know, share in the chat kind of the things that you're take 10 with. Okay, so lots of good things. I really enjoyed Sherry is going to do planning for Boo Buddies. So kind of like a Secret Santa, but a Halloween theme, which I think is really fun, kind of sharing some Halloween themed Secret Santa kinds of gifts and that kind of thing. Super fun. You could do that with fall too, or back to school would be another fun way to do that. So yeah, lots of great ideas there. And I also noticed, like, some folks said, like, the word excite, like, they're like, I don't know if there's anything I'm excited for. And so sometimes the words that we use maybe don't hit quite right. You're like, I don't know if excited is quite the right word. So think about maybe things you're planning for, or things that you're, you know, anticipating, or things that you're looking forward to, right? So something like that is always good. And it's always nice sometimes to have kind of that list of things to kind of look at. Oh, and Kristen says, woohoo, I did it. I struggled too. I mean, that's the kind of cheater thing about the facilitators, is we have this ahead of time. So I've kind of been adding to it all week. So that's the other thing. If you didn't come up with 10, leave that in your journal. Maybe when you'll think of something, probably in the shower, like I always think of something in the shower that I should have written down, then you can fill that up. So you can spend the rest of this month kind of filling up this idea with these kind of take 10 ideas, take 10 things, right? And definitely the grateful part is, it's always good to kind of come things up. And yes, Sherry says, I never complete these during the socials. Not a problem. I've actually heard from several of the Sonder fam who, they come to the socials, they mostly participate in the chat, they take lots of notes, and then they tell their family the social is 2 hours, but then when the social is actually over after an hour, they just play some music and pretend like they're still on the social, and then that's when they actually fill things out. So just a little idea, a little tip there to do. Kim says she does that. Yeah, right. I mean, sometimes you gotta block out time. So whatever works for you to give yourself that time to be able to work on things. All right. So I don't know what kind of week you had, like I said at the beginning, but sometimes we come into these socials, it's Friday, we're kind of frazzled, we're kind of, you know, doing a lot of things. We're kind of, this is another thing that was on our list to do, and we're kind of checking things off. So what I want to do is, I just want to spend a short amount of time with you visualizing a rainstorm before we get into drawing our rainstorm, and just kind of helping ground yourself. Every once in a while, I find myself talking too fast, going too fast, running from one thing to another. And so now I want you to just kind of take just a few minutes. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to play, hopefully you'll be able to, you should be able to hear this little video here. Little mindful moment. Yes, Katie says, to kind of help close out the week. And I forgot to introduce Katie Gideon, my fabulous stage manager, who will be helping out. Oh, there she is. She's waving. Hi, Katie. She's helping us in the chat. So if you have any questions, be sure to check in with her. So what I want you to do is, just, you can close your eyes, you can just kind of avert your gaze, or you can watch a little rainstorm here that I have for us. YouTube is a great place to find this. This actually is 8 hours long. We are not going to be here for 8 hours, but just a minute, 30 seconds. But I want you to kind of take a deep breath. And sometimes it's hard to take a deep breath. We realize we've been really holding a lot in and taking very short, shallow breaths. So just kind of hold it there for just a second. Nice deep breath out. Think about what it feels like when you watch the rain coming in, rainstorm coming in. Clouds start to build. The sky starts to get darker. The air feels different. It's kind of charged sometimes with a little bit of electricity. Start to see that rain kind of falling. Little splatters on the sidewalk, little splatters on the window. Just take some time to breathe here. Think about the smell of the rain. Mm-hmm. Kimberly says she's literally crying. It's so hot and dry and brown. Well, you can, I strongly recommend finding a nice clip on YouTube. Like I said, there's lots of ones that are like eight, this one's 8 hours long. And it's just, and it's a calm app. I just Googled in YouTube, brainstorm and found it and just put that on, close your eyes, and just really kind of think about that rain. All right. So now we're ready to draw our rainstorm, our replenishing rainstorm. So what you're going to do, again, you're going to find a page in your journal. Katie had suggested page 19 for that sketch. If you haven't done your sketch already, it can be on a blank notes page. If you want to make a little rainstorm, you could do it in the little scratch pad section of the week. You can do it on some little post-it notes, in any place that you want to do this writing. And what you're going to do here on this page is you're going to draw some clouds in the air with some raindrops coming down and some lightning coming from it. And don't worry, I'll show you my picture. You have to promise not to laugh, or at least not laugh in the chat. I can't hear you or see you, so I won't actually know if you're laughing. And then I'm going to give you also some other ideas for things you can write so you can start drawing as you want to. So we're going to have some clouds in their sky, raindrops, lightning, and really thinking about rainstorms, how they reset nature by hydrating the earth. And they also release things, right? That's a lot of times what that smell, the rain smell is kind of a release in the air from the rain. And then in that lightning bolt that you draw, you can write out negative things you've been holding on to, maybe things from your past, negative thought patterns, negative interactions that you had this week. And then in your rain clouds, you don't have to necessarily do it in the rain clouds, but you can, or in the raindrops, write some things that give you energy and replenish you. So again, this is a really nice way to kind of visualize some of those things. When you think about what replenishes me, you'll have this nice rainstorm. So here's some other ideas for things that you can draw in your rainstorm page, your replenish rainstorm page, right? Think about rain gear, right? Maybe you want to draw a raincoat. Maybe you want to draw some rubber boots, umbrellas, ponchos. Maybe you want to draw a rain barrel, right? And talk about how you're going to capture all these good things in your rain barrel. You can maybe draw some flowers. You could do a little lightning rod, right? What would be something that could be your lightning rod that will pull away some of those negative things that are coming from the lightning? So here's my picture. This is what my husband was like, "Are you hoping for rain this morning?" So work has been pretty stressful. And this is my main job, not my Silk and Sonder. So just so you know, and boss, the bad boss ideas, but like there's been some very negative things in that space. And then I didn't necessarily think of any other things right now as I was kind of drawing this, but I'm kind of, again, leaving it there. Oh, thank you, Jeannie, for saying you love my picture. I love to draw, but it sometimes is not quite what I visualized in my mind. The other nice thing about this is some of these things you can leave. And again, fill this in anytime you think of something or you kind of want to go back, you want to get into that replenish rainstorm, you can pop back into this scene. And like Katie said, you can build out an entire scene. So I even do have, like, up in the top, I've got my little cloud with some sun peeking out because the sun will come out eventually, right? I've got my little daily affirmations is my umbrella, right? What can kind of help me kind of keep the rain off or maybe to keep me dry? I think of the daily affirmations that we get in our Sonder Club app, or maybe some that I, see in various memes or those kinds of things. I also drew down at the bottom some flowers because rain helps the flowers grow, right? And helps nature. You could draw trees. And I was just kind of thinking of flowers as a symbol of joy, right? The rain kind of helps with my joy. And then you can see when I drew the raindrops, I'm like, okay, now I tried to like write in the raindrops, but then it was kind of small. But I have things in my raindrops, my replenishing raindrops are some things like my cats, iced tea replenishes me, movement, meditation, reading a book, taking a nap, coloring. That was the other thing that was kind of fun with this drawing, is just kind of coloring some things in. The clouds can be kind of those things. They can either be the things that replenish you, because that's what's kind of making all those little raindrops, or it can be the things that maybe frustrate you, or maybe kind of causing some of the lightning. So that's the other thing. So I put in the one cloud, work, because sometimes work can be actually replenishing. I love working with the kids. I love working with our teachers. That part is very replenishing to me. But then the lightning that comes out of work sometimes is the, you know, the boss and some of the things that people, you know, have you do, those kinds of things. Right. And then I drew my little polka dotted galoshes down there at the bottom, thinking about meditation, grounding, keeping your feet dry, those kinds of things. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a couple songs. I'm going to let you spend your time drawing. You can share ideas or questions or thoughts in the chat. I'll pop back in and check and see how everyone's doing. And then we'll just kind of keep working on your replenish rainstorm. And again, if maybe this isn't hitting you quite right, or you're not quite feeling like that, you know, you're into the picture mode, maybe you want to color, right? You want to color in this munch page, absolutely can do that. Maybe you want to do some other doodle on page 19 for replenishing, right? Do what feels good for you. And like I said, what I love about our journal pages is we have them forever, so we can always go back to them later and kind of play with them. Yes. And Candace, thank you for bringing that up. Stickers. Stickers are my friend, right? Got any stickers, got any stencils, maybe even some washi tape or something to kind of decorate your replenish rainstorm. I know we have some fabulous artists in our Sonder fam, because I know a lot of you post after some of these fun exclusive events, you post some of the fun pictures. Definitely looking forward to seeing some of those. So again, I'm going to stop talking, let you work on your replenish rainstorm, and we'll check back in here in just a moment. Thank you. How's everybody doing? I have a feeling you're all drawing and coloring, all those things. And I know I saw Teresa had asked about what to put in the clouds and the raindrops in the ground. So I put this slide back up. You don't have to do it this way. This is just one suggestion. You can put the raindrops can be those things that replenish you. In the clouds can also be things that replenish you. Or maybe there are things that are kind of a mixed bag, right? Because sometimes the storm clouds are gray, but they release ranking of sometimes work has some really good things, but then it can also have some bad things that are kind of like the lightning, those kinds of things. The other thing I had suggested possibly to do would be to put, these little quotes, like find some different quotes about storms and rain and clouds, and maybe kind of write those in the clouds. So kind of thinking about these positive affirmations. And I love someone had put about that she had drawn some flowers. But one of them, Lisa, had said, drew some flowers, but one's a bit bowed by the rain because not all blessings feel like blessings at first, right? How often are things, do things happen and we don't feel like they're a good thing, or maybe they tend to kind of weigh us down or something, but then later on we realize they actually were something that led us to something better or gave us what we needed, even though we didn't know we maybe needed that at the time, right? And then I saw Katie put, for me, the clouds, I have balance and boundaries. The root of my storms, lightning bolts are the frustrations that prevent that balance and boundaries. So love it. Kind of like what do the clouds kind of mean to you? What are you thinking of them? Are you thinking of them as the thing that holds the rain? So they're maybe the good things. Are they the things that are kind of that boundary, or again, the balance, or kind of just overarching things that you're kind of thinking of? So lots of fun ideas. Again, the doing the stickers is great. Amanda, I love that your four-year-old is doing this with you. And the stickers are about autumn. Yes, I 100% feel that vibe. I'm ready for sweater weather, or at least long sleeve weather, all those kinds of things. So what else? Oh, so Jana saying has a productive chores day in the clouds because it replenishes me, because my brain can let go of those. But then it can also be a little draining, right? There's a lot of things, again, like I said, my work, or I can think of lots of things that like there's good and there's bad. There's kind of pros and there's cons. It gives us some things, but maybe it takes some things as well. So again, kind of thinking of what do we do for balance in that? What do we do to help us, you know, replenish what we need to replenish, and think of how we can kind of see the good and maybe some of the not so good or some of the hard things about that. All right. So again, I'm going to put on some more music. I know everyone's busy with their fun pens and maybe even crayons and gel pens and all those kinds of things, stickers. Paula says, wrote, look for the rainbow after the storm. Remember, storms bring growth. So she drew a rainbow to remember. Absolutely. Right. This is a great, like I did in my little picture, because I was like, you know, yes, there's rain, but there's also like this, the sun is there kind of peeking, you know, from behind that cloud. If you've ever been, I always think it's interesting when you're flying and you're up so high and there's the storm clouds underneath you, but you're in the sun, but you can see clearly that there's those gray storm clouds and everyone underneath you is getting rained on while you're enjoying all the sun, because they're both there at the same time. It just depends on where you are and kind of how you're feeling and what that looks like. So again, pop on some music and let you continue to draw, and feel free to share as much about how you're doing your drawing as you would like in the chat.
Thank you.
Right. So lots of really good thoughts. I love how people are really kind of thinking about experiences that maybe were hurtful or maybe very damaging, and how they've kind of used those to grow and to move. And I liked kind of having the Here Comes the Sun kind of pop in, because it goes really nicely with this quote, I think, that says, "And once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain, when you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what the storm's all about." So thinking of rain and thinking of storms and thinking now you have this kind of lovely replenish rainstorm. And it's really nice because it encompasses everything, right? The good and the bad, the things that are hard and the things that replenish us. And so I encourage you to keep working on this throughout the month. I will say there's another social, the Replenish Rainstorm Social, that Jennifer O will be leading on Wednesday, the 23rd. You're welcome to join that as well. Remember, you can join as many socials as you would like throughout the month. That's one of the perks of being in the Sonderfam, right? Is that you can come to any of these socials. Again, like I said, a lot of folks like to use the first one to kind of get ideas and get things going and get a start. And then they come back, you know, to the next one. I love Teresa says, have a little panda in the corner that symbolizes her hubby. So that is awesome. And yeah, I love adding to pictures and kind of thinking of different things. And I'll finish up my little worry worms. I think, I don't know if you saw in the chat, but I was thinking about how worms always kind of come up during rainstorms and because they have a hard time breathing down there, and then the robins come and eat them. So I drew them and called them my worry worms. And then I'm draw some little robins to eat my worry worms. So my worries will nourish something else and not stress me. So Samantha, I'm glad that this was a good break from a stressful week. I hope that everyone feels replenished, feeling good moving into the weekend. Maybe it will rain where you are, maybe not. But you can always, like I said, find some of those fun YouTube videos to kind of watch and listen to and just relax with some of that. And then remember, you need to recharge, replenish, and renew for a better you. So I'm so glad everyone was able to take some time for yourselves today and work on this, your replenish rainstorm. So lots of different QR codes here, and Katie will pop the links into the chat for you. There's a survey, there's the QR code for the survey, so you can let us know things that you like, things you want to see. Veronica, I love that the thunder was rolling where you are, so that worked out nicely. All of these socials really are kind of a product of your suggestions. So please let us know what you would like to see. And especially also if there's better times for you, better times during the day, or you want more on the weekends, or you want more in the evenings, and let us know kind of time zone wise too, kind of what you're thinking. There's also a YouTube link. Make sure you bookmark that. Click on that and bookmark it. So that you can get to the social recordings. It's not, you can't search it. You can't find it on other places. You just have to be able to go to that link. So make sure that you do that. I just realized I need to get my link for, here's the link for the Spotify. And I'll put the song playlist up here in just a second. Hopefully everyone has Sonder Club app. Super positive, great place to go. If you feel comfortable posting your pictures there, that would be lovely. We love to see those there. They're very inspiring. Plus they will help Jennifer O have some more pictures for her social. So you might be featured if you post your picture. And we have a new program over here on the left-hand side. If you love Silk and Sonder and you maybe want to refer a friend, you want someone else to kind of get in on the goodness that is Silk and Sonder, scan that QR code. It will take you to a page where you can kind of enter in, I think, like your friend's email, that kind of thing. And I believe it's you get a referral bonus and they get a discount. And I want to say it's $10, but I'm not 100% sure. So make sure you kind of pop on that There'll be more information coming about that. This is a new program that they're offering, kind of this refer a friend program, kind of a fun way to bring people together. So Crystal, I'm so glad that you felt like you needed this and feeling good. I'm so glad everyone was here. I feel better. I'm ready to go into the weekend. Now I get to clean up the house for the carpet cleaners to come tomorrow. So have a fabulous weekend. Tomorrow afternoon is the cooking social with Karen and I. So you don't have to cook. You can pop on and watch Karen cook and hear us chat. We love to visit. We'll be doing the recipe that's in this month's journal. And have a fabulous, fabulous weekend. And we will hopefully see you soon.